Back in 2014, the original Lords of the Fallen was one of the first attempts to replicate From Software's Dark Souls formula. However, the game failed to achieve the same level of success. And now in 2023, we have a new attempt, this time with a sequel slash reboot under the same name, Lords of the Fallen, which is developed by Hexworks using Unreal Engine 5 with Lumen and Nanite. And thanks to these UE5 features, the game shines when it comes to lighting and especially the geometric complexity. However, in terms of the overall polish and the performance and stability, it's safe to say that it falls short. That's why today in this video, we'll discuss the technical issues and as usual, we'll examine each graphic settings, performance and visual impact. But before that, a quick word from today's video sponsor, Awesome. This is a free-to-download software that allows you to remotely access, control and manage your PC from your mobile device anytime from anywhere, and it's compatible with Windows, iOS and Android. Moreover, the software goes beyond that, as with the paid version, you can play your PC games on your phone with up to 144 FPS. Like here, I am playing Lords of the Fallen, and the app offers a lot of customization, especially for keyboard keys and controls. You can put as many keys as you like and you can save them as presets, and they even offer a pre-made layouts for popular games. And they also have a smart power plug that allows you to shut down or turn on your PC remotely, making remote control even more convenient with fewer drawbacks. As an added benefit, you can enjoy up to 40% discount on your purchase, or you can obtain the gaming version for free by using my code, which provides a 7-day free trial for the first 200 users. So go ahead and download now, and big thank you to Awesome for sponsoring this video. Now, the game has a lot of technical problems. First, we have the unstable frame time when traversing the game world. Like here, you can see how the frame time graph is all over the place. And this is an issue that plagued the majority of Unreal Engine 4 games, and it seems like Unreal Engine 5 still has the same problem, which is a shame. Another big issue related to the first one is the occasional massive FPS drops. Like here, you can see how every time I roll or I sprint, the performance drops significantly with low GPU usage. And I found that the only workaround for this problem is to exit to the main menu and reload the game. And now, as you can see, the performance is much better. And of course, as in Unreal Engine 5 with Lumen and Nanite, the game is so intensive, especially when trying to play at native resolution with max settings. And upscaling will be necessary for most users to achieve good performance, and for that we have DLSS and FSR. And here, if we compare the two, we can see the usual results, with DLSS offering more stable image while retaining more details, and FSR have noticeable noise and shimmering. And during fast animations, FSR falls apart, as you can see here. However, the DLSS implementation in this game is not perfect either, as it exhibits noticeable smearing on small and thin objects when in motion, which causes noise artifacts around these objects, as you can see here. And the same problem occurs even at native resolution with DLAA. And upscaling is not the only way to get better performance. So let's examine the graphic settings, starting with view distance. Now, in this game, Nanite is only used for large buildings and rocks. Other elements such as foliage, trees and ground details relies on traditional level of detail system. And the view distance setting controls the draw distance and LOD for these elements. Like here, you can see how higher options have more ground details, and as a result, using low, as you can see here, causes a lot of pop-in, and going to medium lower it a little bit, but it's still there. Only high and above look acceptable with minimal pop-in. And performance wise, going from low to medium costs around 3%, to high 4% and to ultra 5%. So for this one, I recommend high or ultra. Next we have shadows, which is one of the most demanding settings in this game. This one is straightforward. It controls the resolution of shadows, as you can see here, and also the view distance, as medium and low shadows appear much closer to the camera compared to high and ultra. And on the performance side, going from low to medium costs around 2%. However, going to high costs 15% and to ultra 20%. So here I recommend medium, but if you have enough performance to spare, go for high to further enhance the sharpness of shadows. Moving on to anti-aliasing, this one controls the quality of the game's TAA. Like here, you can see how as I move the camera, ultra looks more stable compared to low. And And performance wise, going from low to even ultra costs around 4%. So for this one, I recommend ultra, especially if you are playing at a lower resolution. Now for textures, Unreal Engine 5 is pretty much similar to Unreal Engine 4, as the texture setting here mainly controls the amount of allocated VRAM instead of the actual quality of textures. As you can see here, all four options look identical, because as long as you have enough VRAM, the game will load the highest possible textures, regardless of the texture option you choose. And in terms of the VRAM usage during normal gameplay, even at native 1440p with ultra textures, the allocated VRAM never went close or exceeded 6.5GB. But the problem with textures in this game is the poor quality of the anisotropic filtering used, as you can see here, and unfortunately there is no setting to control it. The only way to improve it is by using the driver control panel. By going to manage 3D settings, then go to program settings, look for Lords of the Fallen, and after that go to anisotropic filtering and set it to 16x. And don't forget to apply. And here you can see now that textures look much better with minimal impact on performance. The visual effect quality setting controls the density of some particle effects, like the smoke effect as you can see here, and it also affects the quality of water surface and water simulation effects, like here, where low and medium have limited simulation effects when interacting with water, unlike high and ultra. And on the performance side, low and medium perform similarly, and going to high costs around 2% and to ultra 3%. So here for my optimized settings, I recommend at least high visual effect quality. Post-processing adjusts the quality and complexity of post-processing effects, like bloom as you can see here, where low and medium disable this effect while high and ultra enable it. And for this one, going from low to ultra have negligible performance impact. The second effect is depth of field, which is more noticeable during cutscenes like here, and we can see that low disable this effect completely. And performance wise in this particular cutscene, going from low to medium costs 2%, to high 4%, and to ultra around 6%. And lastly, we have motion blur, and it's similar to depth of field, with low disabling this effect, even if it's enabled in the menu. And here it's hard to measure the performance, but on average, medium and high perform almost similarly, with 5% cost from low, and ultra cost 9%. So this one is purely down to your personal preference. If you like these effects, use high as it enables bloom and provides a higher quality depth of field compared to medium, with minimal impact on the performance. Next we have reflection quality. This one controls the resolution of reflections as you can see here. And these reflections scale with the in-game resolution. Like here you can see how low with DLSS looks low res compared to low at native resolution. And according to the settings menu description, it says that high and above enabled ray traced reflections. But I haven't noticed any visible evidence of this. You can see here that even ultra has screen space artifacts caused by these insects. And the biggest indication that there is no ray tracing, at least here at this area and many other areas I've examined, is the performance, where going from low to even ultra costs around 4%. So here I recommend ultra, especially if you're playing with DLSS or FSR. Moving on to global illumination quality, this one controls the quality of the game's indirect lighting and ambient occlusion. Like here, you can see how low and medium look identical, and moving to high fix some light leakage and improves the accuracy of the game's lighting. But moving to ultra enhances the ambient occlusion and adds more bounced lighting. And performance wise, going from low to medium costs around 1%, to high 4%, and to ultra 22%. So here I recommend medium or high. And last but definitely not least, we have foliage quality. This one controls the density of the game's foliage, and as a result it also affects the terrain quality, like here. You can see how going from off to other settings drastically changed the shape of the terrain. And performance wise, this is the most demanding one, because going from off to medium costs around 10%, to high 23%, and to ultra 27%. So here, even if off provides great performance, I really don't recommend it, as it negatively impacts the game's visuals. Therefore, avoid off and use medium, and if you have enough performance, go for high foliage. Now, based on everything we saw so far, these are my recommended settings. Now the game has two worlds layered on top of each other. We have the world of the living, Axiom, and if we use the lamp, we can take a look at Umbral, the world of the dead. And we can even transition to the other world using the same lamp. And from my experience, Umbral performs worse compared to Axiom. That's why we will do two runs to compare optimized settings and ultra presets, one for Axiom and one for Umbral. So let's start with Axiom, and I am running the game at 1440p with DLSS quality on both sides. And here in this area, we can see that on average, optimized settings boost performance by around 70%. However, in Umbral, that difference slightly decreases, where we can see that optimized settings perform around 61% better compared to Ultra presets. And with that, we arrive at the end. Thank you so much for watching and for your time. If you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and if not, leave a dislike. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell for future videos, and hopefully I'll see you all in the next one.